Hello and welcome. This is a short video for SD Bullion's 21st Century Gold Rush Guide. For anyone watching on YouTube, simply visit sdbullion.com/book for more information. Here we will cover physical platinum reality, as well as current platinum supply and platinum demand factors today. Let's begin with platinum's supply chain, not merely from the ground, nor an electrical man-made derivative. Platinum is born from the most violent event we humans know of, star explosions. Scientifically explained, planets including our own form from epic collisions between asteroids and even bigger bodies called protoplanets. Sometimes the colliding bodies are ground to dust, and sometimes they stick together to ultimately form larger, mature planets. Platinum's properties. Humans, in only the past few centuries, have become able to produce fire conditions hot enough to melt, refine, and identify platinum properly. The melt point for platinum is very high at more than 3,200 degrees Fahrenheit. Platinum, in its above-ground form, is much more rare than silver or gold. All the silver ever mined shaped into a cube would have 52-meter sides. All the gold ever mined would be a cube with 20-meter sides. But all the platinum ever mined in the shape of a cube would have sides of less than 8 meters. The cube would be so small, it could fit inside an average 2-car garage. Platinum is the least reactive metal and has extraordinary resistance to corrosion and tarnish. Platinum is also perhaps as highly ductile as gold. A platinum wire drawn down from a rod 10 centimeters long with a 1 centimeter diameter could be stretched to extend from New York City past Denver, Colorado. Platinum has a higher density than silver or gold, and therefore takes up less space or square footage when stored. Platinum supply. South African mines produce more than 70% of the annual world's platinum supply. South Africa also has a long, sordid history of mining labor strikes, high multi-generational disparities in wealth, cultural instability, and political turmoil. Thus, the world's supply of platinum is much more vulnerable to disruption compared to other more widely mined physical precious metals like silver and gold. 2006 was the peak platinum production year, with South Africa producing more than 5 million ounces and Russia nearly a million ounces. Mining costs have risen, ore grades have decreased. Therefore, since 2006, Russia and South African platinum supplies have declined, but recycling platinum has helped the market keep up with demand. Platinum demand. Global demand for platinum is just over 7 million ounces per year. Demand for platinum comes from four major sectors: industry, jewelry, car manufacturing, and investment. Platinum price. Since the beginning of the 21st century, the world has witnessed a pronounced general increase in platinum's value priced in every national currency. Investment demand for platinum has continued to grow even after its massive price drop from its 2008 all-time high. Platinum investments range from derivative electronic shares of platinum ETFs to actual physical platinum bullion coins and bars. If you think investing in physical platinum bullion is right for you, go to sdbullion.com/platinum to see some of the investment-grade physical platinum you can buy and take direct delivery of right now. This concludes our platinum fundamental video for SD Bullion's free 21st Century Gold Rush Guide. If you want to learn more about current platinum price discovery mechanics and how the platinum price is derived, visit us at sdbullion.com/book, where you can find more information in the Platinum Fundamentals section. If you like this video and content, be sure to like and subscribe to our official SD Bullion YouTube channel for free research and educational content. Goodbye for now, and thanks for watching.